Today we're going to cut up a red oak, 6 foot, 3 inch red oak. It's really a crotch. It's going to be a little problematic to get it in between, to keep it in between the knees of the sawmill. But we're going to do that. We're going to run over to the Silbot Ranch where I got the log. We'll come back here and mill this red oak up. And we're also going to go out to West Texas. And I gave one of my friends a black gum, and he milled it up on a Woodmizer LT35. But first off, I got to put liquid propane in this tank. I'm going to show you how we do that out here on the ranch, and then we're going to get after it and mill this red oak up. Probably mill it into 1x12s, 6 foot long, maybe some 4x4s. I need some 4x4s to put down a skidding. Whenever I lift the log, let's see if this old Betsy will start. This is a 250-gallon propane tank. This is a dip tube that goes to the bottom of the tank where the liquid is. This hose here will connect to that yellow port right there. I don't open this wide open. I crack it open, ease into it, because there is a blowout relief valve here. It's not a relief valve, it just chokes down on it. If it detects fluids coming out or gas is coming out quickly, sometimes it'll stop that flow. And we've got it connected here. Really, all I've got to do is bleed the air out of it now. There you go. I'm going to close this back now. Open this to the tank. 20% there. So I'm just going to gently and slowly turn this on. Okay, you can hear it going through there now. Now, propane's a refrigerant, so this tank is cold. I should have brought my laser thermometer. Now what I'm gonna do is open the bleed valve. This will blow liquid when there's 80%. Let me get a wrench. That gauge is probably off a little bit because I trust this right here has a little dip too that runs down to the bottom also. Well, it runs down to 80%, or up to 80%, I should say. When the effluent is liquid instead of gas, we're at 80%. A subscriber asked how this tractor, this 1964 case, connects to the sawmill. It's through this PTO right here. It's pretty simple. Goes to the shaft or the mandrel, all the way to the blade, and then that pulley drives this mechanism which makes the carriage go back and forth. And then on the tractor, it's that. That engages it. That's the PTO. Always make sure it's in neutral. And we've also got this other clutch that's on the transmission. I keep that down so it cannot go forward. All right, here's the red oak I got from my uncle's ranch. It is 19 by 15, and it's got this limb. It's going across here, huge. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this off with my chainsaw. I could do it with the mill, it'd just take me forever because of the clearance between that tiller handle and that cage and all that. I'd be hitting that with the log. So anyway, this end is 16
by 16. Let's get her done.
Loading a piece of red oak. Law, gonna take it to the Triple T sawmill and cut it up. How you doing, man?
Tell me, how long you been running this ranch?
I've been running it since 2008. Just me alone and some help, hired help, but I worked on it as a teenager as well with Dad, and he run registered Herefords on here for 31 years.
Yeah. How long did you work overseas?
I worked overseas. I'm still doing a little overseas. 45 years. This is going on 46.
And how old are you?
30 countries. 30 different countries I worked in. I'm 68, be 69 June of 27.
And still active?
Still active. I got a 51 Chevrolet pickup that's still working, and I'm still working same model.
6'3" log that fell off my log feed about three times. But I've got 1x12s here. Come off the soapbox ranch. Then I kind of made me some 4x4s. They're really like 4x5s. There's my red oak sawdust. Well, camera girl just come over here and asked me why I wasn't flying my flag on 4th of July weekend. So a little bit too late. There she is. And while I'm doing this, I might as well feed the minners. Come get your barbecue. Let's break away from here now and go to Big Spring, Texas, the home of the Midnight Cowboy. It's also the home of Soloman Sawmill. He's gonna cut up some black gum and some walnut. I hope you enjoyed going out to West Texas, seeing Mike cut up some walnut and black gum, and also cutting up the red oak that we got from a tree that fell down on the Silbach Ranch. So that was a good 4th of July weekend. Hope y'all have a blessed week.